Hello friends, today we will have some one-liners, best one-liners with IMP facts for UGC NET, SET, TGT, PGT, DSSP, PhD entrance exams, as well as other exams also of English literature, MCQs and one-liners, literary criticism and theory unit. It is. So let's begin. First of all, we are having the first question. Who introduced the term Dasein, which literally means being there? So it was Martin Heidegger. And one important fact I have for this question: Martin Heidegger was a German philosopher. Dasein is a fundamental concept in his existential philosophy. Okay, in his existential philosophy, this concept is there. This term was introduced in his text, Being and Time. So this is very important text published in 1927, in which this particular term was introduced by Martin Heidegger. Don't forget. Okay, so and it means being there. Next question is there. The term interpretative communities was introduced by Stanley Fish in his essay, Interpreting the Variorum. Okay, so this is an essay by Stanley Fish published in 1976. And the term interpretative communities was introduced there in that essay. This is a concept originated from reader response criticism. So if you are asked with a new question that with which concept the term interpretative communities belong, or it is there. So it is reader response criticism from which it was originated and popularized by Stanley Fish. Then moving ahead, the third question, the term implied reader was introduced by Wolfgang Iser. Wolfgang Iser introduced that term, implied reader. And what does it mean? So implied reader is a hypothetical figure, an imaginative figure. Okay, we can say hypothetically, we assume that there is a reader. So it is an hypothetical reader. The implied reader is a book by him also in 1974. Iser says, when an author writes a book or articles, they do so with certain readers in mind, and they believe that those known as the implied reader will understand or appreciate the metaphors and ironies which the author has written. So it is implied by the author. Okay, hypothetically. Then, next question, provincializing Europe is a concept propounded by Dipesh Chakravarti. Dipesh Chakravarti propounded this concept, provincializing Europe, and it is a book by him, and it has its full title, Provincializing Europe and Postcolonial Thought and Historical Difference. It is its full title. Okay, and it was published in 2000. In the year 2000, it proposes that every case of transition to capitalism is a case of translation as well. Then moving ahead, the next question, the term cultural materialism is associated with Raymond Williams. We all know about him. He is from the theory cultural studies, cultural materialism, and it is a theory viewing culture as a productive process focusing on arts and literature. A book is written entitled on Raymond Williams, that Cultural Materialism on Raymond Williams. It is a book written by Christopher Prendergast. This book is written by him on Raymond Williams. It may be asked in exam, that's why I have added the detail here. And this book was published in 1995. Then ahead, Roman Jakobson was associated with Prague School of Structuralists. Russian formalism, it is also known as. Roman Jakobson was an American linguist and a pioneer of structural linguistics. Okay, he is known as the American linguist and as the pioneer of structural linguistics. Then, one more question from the Prague School. Language is a coherent system fulfilling a range of functions in society, is a belief of Prague School. Okay, that is a belief of Prague School. Prague School was also known as Prague Linguistic Circle, established in 1926 by Wilhelm Mathesius. Don't forget, by Wilhelm Mathesius, it was established in 1926. And it is also known as Prague Linguistic Circle. And while analyzing folktale, who identified 31 functions to be found in every folktale? So Vladimir Prop identified 31 functions to be found in each folktale. Okay, so he analyzed the folktale and he found 31 functions there. He analyzed it in his book, Morphology of the Folktale. So don't forget this. Morphology of the Folktale is a book by Vladimir Prop, in which he analyzed 31 functions to be found in each folktale. And this book was published in 1928, which was translated into English in 1958. Okay, it is important fact. It is considered as one of the major works in oral literature. So folktale, we all know that it is oral literature. Orally, the people are saying tales and mythological stories. Okay, so this is considered as one of the major works. Which work? Morphology of the Folktale by Vladimir Prop. This work is considered as one of the major works in oral literature, published in 1928 and then translated into English in 1958. Then ninth question, who wrote about the Black experiences in New Ethnicities? Stuart Hall from Cultural Studies. Okay, so Stuart Hall, a student of Richard Hogarth, he wrote about the Black experiences in his essay, New Ethnicities. Stuart Hall, let's learn something more about him. He was the founder of New Left Review Journal. He was the founder. Okay, New Left Review Journal he started. A popular cultural theorist he was. And he was the director of CCS. What is CCS? Center for Contemporary Cultural Studies after Hogarth. Richard Hogarth, his master, began this center. He established this center. And he was as the director of this center. After Hogarth, that place was occupied by Stuart Hall. Okay, so Stuart Hall was the second director of CCS. And this essay, New Ethnicities, is his essay published in 1988. Last question of this video. Who named John Dryden as Glorious John? Walter Scott. Walter Scott named John Dryden as Glorious John. As we all know that John Dryden was the great critic, was the great poet, was the great writer of his time. That's why he was named as Glorious John by Walter Scott. Okay, so that's all for today's session, friends. It is very small session, but I hope that it was very, very fruitful and helpful session for you. This video, the questions I covered here, all the questions are exam oriented, that may be asked in exam in one or another way. So don't forget to copy these questions with the answers, with the facts, and you can also take screenshots. Okay, no problem with that. But don't forget to subscribe this channel, because this channel is a free channel for all the students, for all the aspirants. There is nothing in this channel for those who can pay. I am not asking for any kind of payment. This is a free channel for all. Okay, with the free videos and free video content. It is there on my blog also. You can find so many files in the PDF form on my blog. So that's all for today. We'll meet very soon. Thank you so much.